The Office of Civil Defense is proposing to turn Mayon Volcano's 6-kilometer permanent danger zone into a national park. If the proposal pushes through, the OCD says it would keep residents away from the area and in turn reduce the need for evacuations when the volcano rumbles.
Almost every 4, every 5 years, apat limang taon, nangyayari pa ulit-ulit eh. Yung resources po ng gobyerno, paulit-ulit ding madidrain sa halip na gamitin natin sa ibang mga proyekto. So sa madaling salita, kailangan po, agree po ako, kailangan ng mas permanente at sustainable long-term solution.
All right, for more on that proposal, we're now joined by Gremil Naz of the OCD Bicol Region. Gremil, good morning to you.
Hello, ma'am. Good morning.
All right, Gremil, can you face your camera, your laptop? There. All right. So first, what will it take for that 6-kilometer danger zone around Mayon to actually be declared as a national park?
For OCD 5, we need to get the support of the local government units and we need to have a support from our lawmakers to ensure that the 6-kilometer permanent danger zone be converted into a national park.
Okay. And how big of an area are we talking about? Because clearly, we can only imagine 6 kilometers, but this is, of course, surrounding Mayon. How big is this area and how many LGUs does it cover?
Currently, I don't have the data on how large the size of the 6-kilometer permanent danger zone area, but it will encompass at least 7 municipalities since there are municipalities and cities sharing the area of Mayon volcano slopes.
Okay. And how many actually live within the 6-kilometer danger zone? Because am I right so far that roughly close to 40,000, is it families right now or individuals have been evacuated?
Currently in our data, we only have approximately 20,000 persons or more or less 6,000 families who are currently evacuated in different evacuation centers and outside evacuation centers. And the number of families that are being targeted to be relocated is roughly 6,000 to 7,000 families. They may be relocated outside the 6-kilometer permanent danger zone.
So where does the 39,000 count come from?
39,000
people, individuals. That's what I'm reading.
This is based on our report from the DSWD. Okay. And the 39,000 are the affected population, ma'am. Okay. These are the families and persons who are feeling the effects of the current status of Mayon volcano, but most of them or some of them are not evacuated, especially the municipalities of Bacacay and some municipalities like Camalig, because the effects of the ashfall are being felt by the population, but they are well outside the 7-kilometer extended danger zone.
I see. Okay. Now, what will it take to turn the area into a national park, other than you mentioned you need the support of lawmakers, the LGU? Has there been a precedent or precedent when it comes to this?
For how many years? I think decades. The problem is that the families and persons living inside the 6-kilometer permanent danger zone would not like to relocate to other areas since their source of livelihood is within the 6-kilometer permanent danger zone. And based on my experience, most of them are farmers and they're utilizing the rich and fertile soil of Mayon in order for them to have their income through selling of vegetables and other goods.
Okay, that's good. So is it possible then, as another model, that that area will be used for farming, but then not for residents? I'm just imagining, of course, a national park is different completely, right? That would mean you'd have to plant trees instead of vegetables to be harvested. Pero is that another possible model, that it becomes a farming community, but then you're not allowed to build houses within the 6 kilometers?
We do hope that some of the area can still be utilized as farmlands for OCD 5. But at the national level, we do not know what would be the provisions in turning the Mayon Volcano 6-kilometer permanent danger zone into a national park. And we do hope that if this comes into fruition, the different government agencies would also be providing alternative source of livelihood and also other sources of income, since most of the evacuees are farmers and they have been farmers for generations, including their fathers and their earlier families or ancestors.
Yeah, but then there's also a political aspect to this, diba, Gremil, because then they are technically also voters of that particular LGU. Kumbaga, yung sinabi mo, may pito. There are 7 municipalities that cover the 6-kilometer danger zone. So if they're moved out, they can't be moved to just one municipality or turned over there. The LGU would still want them.
Yes, ma'am. That is the problem. Aspect.
Yeah.
So the problem is that the earlier politicians are having a hard time, including the national government agencies, since they are very hesitant. There are also plans from the different local chief executives, but it didn't bear fruit since the families are very hesitant to leave, since the source of income is within the 6-kilometer permanent danger zone.
Okay. And is there any other area other than the 6-kilometer permanent danger zone where land is also... It's kumbaga, it's as fertile as it is near the volcano.
Yes, ma'am. 7 to 8 kilometers, the 7 to 8 kilometers extended danger zone are also still being utilized as agricultural land, since it's very fertile due to Mayon volcano. So once we raise the alert status to level 4, we'll also be looking at the possibility of doubling the number of evacuees, since there are also more than thousands of families living in the 7-kilometer extended danger zone.
Okay, so you've seen the behavior of Mayon. It is the most active volcano that we have, but you're seeing right now at night, there's a lava flowing out at night, I believe. And right now, kumbaga na mamaga pa daw, right? It is still, it's spewing. But slowly, it's not like an immediate eruption. So is this unique to you as a local? What are your thoughts?
I think Mayon Volcano is very unique because besides the scenarios that were presented by Secretary Solidum during President Marcos's visit and during the time of the former resident volcanologist who is very close to us, Sir Ed Laguerta, he tells us that Mayon Volcano is very unique since it heals itself through lava flow. So the problems or the concerns that Mayon Volcano is not a perfect volcano, Dr. Laguerta and also Dr. Alanis told us that it's healing itself slowly through lava flow.
Uh-oh. But then when you say it heals itself through lava flow, what does that mean now for the people living around it?
That is the concern, ma'am, since we still have families in the 6-kilometer permanent danger zone. And we see the Mayon volcano not as a threat for Albayanos, but is also source of income for some of the families. So it's very important that we address the concerns of the general population, especially those living in the 6-kilometer permanent danger zone.
Okay, and now the number of tourists wanting to see the lava flow from Mayon is increasing. What are your thoughts about what's now being coined as disaster tourism?
Through dialogues with the different agencies, including Department of Tourism, the current status of Mayon does not need for any ban on tourism or suspension of tourism activities outside the 6-kilometer permanent danger zone. Tourists are encouraged to view what is happening in Legazpi or other parts of Albay, but we recommend to utilize the viewing decks because we have viewing points situated on the different municipalities and cities in Albay.
Oo, kumbaga, it's a part of life. Tanggap nyo na yun.
Yes, ma'am. And we have safe vantage points, and the Department of Tourism Regional Office 5 encourages that Albay is still safe. Albay is safe, especially the outside kilometer, the 6 kilometer permanent danger zone and the extended danger zones.
All right. Okay. In terms of the evacuees, I'm sure that we've had 2014 and 2018. How different is it in 2023, what the evacuees are experiencing?
The main difference at the moment is due to the current protocols for COVID-19. We're still following the COVID protocols, even for hydrometeorological hazards such as typhoon here in Bicol. And that is the current protocol that we are looking into, because it's different from what happened from the past two major eruptions of Mayon Volcano in 2014 and 2018. So we are ensuring that the COVID protocols are still being followed.
Okay. On that note, I want to thank you so much, Gramil, for joining me today. Mag-ingat po kayo. Thank you. That's Gramil Naz of the Office of Civil Defense